Hello friends, welcome to the lecture of functional analysis. In the last lecture we have seen the concept of open mapping theorem. Now in today's lecture we will go for an interesting part which is an application of an open mapping theorem, that is a Banach's theorem, and also we will move ahead towards the closed graph theorem. Let me share my screen. So for now, in today's lecture, first we will try to understand what is Banach's theorem. Banach's theorem is very interesting. Suppose we have two Banach spaces B and B dash, and T is a 1-1 continuous linear transformation of B onto B dash. Then our aim is to prove that T is homeomorphism. Okay. Actually, this theorem is giving us an alternative definition, for the homeomorphism. Homeomorphism is the concepts you have seen in detail in the paper of general topology. Therefore, first let me write the statement of Banach's theorem. Then we will discuss what is homeomorphism, and then we will go to understand the proof of the theorem. The proof of the theorem is directly or obviously hold from the open mapping theorem. It is of two lines only, but the concept to understand is important. So let me write the statement first. The theorem tells us that let B and B dash be Banach spaces. B and B dash be the Banach spaces, and T B a 1-1 continuous linear transformation. Of B onto B dash, then T is homeomorphism. Okay, we will not go to the proof of the theorem directly. Therefore, let me change the color of my pen to understand this. I'm just taking the definitions. First, we'll try to recall what is T is homeomorphism. We have studied already that what is homeomorphism. Homeomorphism is a mapping having the properties 1-1 onto, and both the mapping and its inverse are continuous. Therefore, let me write a general definition. If F is a mapping from a metric space X to Y, then F is homeomorphism if F is 1-1 onto, 1-1 onto, and F and F inverse are continuous. Therefore, in all, how many properties we need? 4 properties. First, 1-1 onto, F continuous and F inverse continuous. Now, if we look at the statement, how many properties are already given? 1-1 given, the mapping continuous given, linear given. Therefore, what remains to prove? The mapping inverse is continuous. Therefore, proving the theorem means proving T to be homeomorphism is just particularly or equivalent to proving T inverse is continuous. Proving T inverse is continuous. But if we just recall the open mapping theorem, these all are the assumptions in the open mapping theorem. That is T from B to B dash, Banach spaces, this is 1-1 continuous linear transformation of B onto B dash. And we have proved that this mapping is an open mapping. Okay. Therefore, let me write in short the theorem, open mapping. This is the first basic concept to recall. This is the second open mapping theorem. We have studied in the last lecture. What is open mapping theorem? If B and B dash are Banach spaces, B and B dash are the Banach spaces, and T is continuous linear transformation. Continuous linear transformation of B on to B dash, then T is open. T is open. What is open? T is open means it takes open sets to open sets. Therefore, here the assumptions are both the spaces are banana. The mapping T is continuous and linear. Therefore, here all the conditions are satisfied. Here in our theorem also. Therefore, one may say that T is an open mapping. Now, if T is open, will it gives the equivalent statement that T inverse is continuous, and we want to claim the same. That is, the mapping T is open equivalently gives us T inverse is continuous. We will try to understand this by the third statement. Therefore, what we want to prove, or what we want to observe from the definition, that T inverse is continuous, is equivalent to T is open mapping. T is open mapping. Now, if this holds, if this is correct, say if this holds, then in above theorem, the mapping is open. Therefore, T inverse is continuous, and hence it will be a homeomorphism. Now, we'll try to understand how these two are equivalent. That is, T inverse is continuous is equivalent to the mapping is open. Now, what we know the fact. If the mapping F is continuous, suppose if F is any mapping from X to Y is given to be continuous, what the theorem says that it pulls back the open sets to open sets. That is, whenever F, this is continuous, if F inverse G is open in X, whenever G is open in Y, okay, that is, this is my X, this is say Y, and this is an open set G in Y, and this is a F image, as this is given to be onto 1 1, means inverse exists. Therefore, inverse will be from Y to X. Then for what is the inverse image of G? Inverse image of G is a subset of X, and we will denote it by F inverse G. Therefore, the mapping continuous, we know that if F inverse G is open in X, whenever G is open in Y. That is, G open in Y implies F inverse G open in X. Okay, therefore, if the same concepts we will apply for F inverse is continuous, what will be the change? We will use same concept for F inverse is a continuous. F inverse is continuous. Therefore, surely F inverse will be a mapping from Y to X. Therefore, according to the statement, whenever we have G open in X, its inverse image under F inverse. What will be the inverse image under F inverse? This is the mapping, its inverse image, right? But what is inverse of an inverse? This is F of G is open in Y. Therefore, what it is gives us? G open in X implies FG open in X, and which is nothing but the mapping F is open. Therefore, whenever we are saying F is open, it is equivalent to F inverse is continuous. F inverse is continuous, right? I hope there is no difficulty. If you have a difficulty, you can ask me at any time, no doubt. Therefore, what we have proved, F, the mapping F is open is equivalent to say that F inverse is continuous. Now, coming back to the proof of main Banach's theorem. What Banach's theorem is having the assumptions, 1 1 continuous linearity, on 2 is also assumption, only that is T is homeomorphism. But to prove homeomorphism, we write, we want only T is an open mapping. Therefore, let me start the proof. Okay, what is given? T is a mapping from B to B dash. How many properties it possess? 1, 1, on 2, continuous, linear. Right, these many properties the mapping possess. Therefore, by open mapping theorem, by open mapping theorem, by open mapping theorem, may I write T is open mapping? T is open mapping. And just now we have proved the mapping open. It equivalently means that T inverse is continuous. Therefore, all the assumptions satisfied now. 1, 1 on 2, T continuous and T inverse is also continuous, which implies T is homeomorphism. Homeomorphism. Interesting proof, no? Therefore, one can tell the equivalent definition of homeomorphism. What is the equivalent definition of homeomorphism? Let us write. Equivalent definition of homeomorphism. Of homeomorphism. What is the equivalent definition? Homeomorphism. Or homeomorphism. Is 1, 1 continuous mapping. 1, 1 continuous mapping of one, we'll write general, no? Therefore, from one topological space, from one topological space onto another, which is an open mapping, because this open gives us the inverse is continuous. Hence all the conditions, 1, 1 continuous, mapping continuous, mapping and its inverse continuous. Therefore, this is an equivalent definition of homeomorphism. Therefore, this is a quite interesting theorem given by Banach, that if we have 1, 1 continuous linear transformation from a Banach space onto another Banach space, then this is homeomorphism also. Okay. Now, this is for the first concept we want to discuss today. Now, I want to go to a next concept of closed graph theorem. Now, the point name is closed graph theorem. We are not going directly for the theorem. Before understanding, we have to understand what is graph, what is the norm on the graph, whether it is a Banach space or not, etc. and etc. And finally, we will go for closed graph theorem. Therefore, this was a heading. We are going to understand what is closed graph theorem. Let me tell you again, the next theorem we were discussing is not closed graph theorem. All those theorems were necessary for the proof of closed graph theorem. First, we will try to understand the definition of what is graph. Okay, graph of T, graph of any mapping. Graph of T. Okay, we have studied this somewhere in 12th standard itself. Huh? If F is any mapping, if F is if any function given, Y equal to f of x, we are plotting an image. Okay, plotting means we are collecting all points which are satisfying this relation y equal to f of x. Rather, it is a locus of collection of all such points. Therefore, how can we write a coordinate of every element on that curve? X, y is nothing but f of x. Therefore, this is a collection of all the elements of the type x f of x, and whatever is the locus collected, we are calling it as a graph. Therefore, the same definition we are using here as a graph of T in case of nonlinear spaces. Okay, and therefore, let me write, let N and N dash be the normed linear spaces and T be a mapping from N to N dash, B be mapping with domain n and range in n dash. See, we are not saying range n dash. See, we are saying range in n dash means the mapping is into. Okay, then let me go to the next page. The graph of T is defined to be a subset of n cross n dash which consists of all ordered pairs x tx it is denoted by tg. Okay, in some books the notation is gt. T suffix g is a graph of T, or g suffix t. Okay, accordingly we have to go for the notation. Therefore, what is tg defined? I'll use tg. Okay, what is tg defined? Tg defined is collection of all ordered pair x tx, which is no doubt an element of a Cartesian product for x in n. Okay, this is very similar to this graph we have drawn. This is an element of x cross y, na, ordered pair, Cartesian product of the two axes, that is R2 space, right? Therefore, similarly, graph of any mapping T is a subset of a Cartesian product n cross n dash, and we are defining this by collection of all ordered pairs of the type x, tx, right? Now, the next job we are going to do is, we will prove that this n cross n dash, a Cartesian product, is a norm linear space, and is complete as well with some conditions. What those conditions and all, we will see in the theorem itself. But before that, we will discuss how the norm is being defined. Therefore, here we will discuss norm on the Cartesian product n cross n dash. Okay, there are many, there are different kinds of norm defined. Now we will see one norm defined here. Suppose xy is an ordered pair belonging to n cross n dash, then norm of this ordered pair xy is defined to be norm x plus norm y. This is one norm, rather I will say. This is one norm. If I can, if I want to show you this in an R2 space, assuming that xy belongs to R2, for the sake of proving the, for the sake of understanding the geometric interpretation, then here will be a location somewhere, xy, this is my x axis, this is my y axis, right? Then where will be norm x plus norm y? Okay, what about this? This is y, na? And this is x. Okay, norm xy is actually distance of this vector xy, from origin, and we have seen already norm not necessarily gives us the shortest distance obtained by joining the two vectors by the straight line. Therefore, here the norm is defined to be norm x plus norm y. Now we already know that this much distance is x and this much distance is y. Then norm x. Now here if I take norm x to be this much distance, that is say norm x, and this be norm y. Then norm of xy is defined to be an addition. Therefore, distance is calculated as, here is my xy, right? Let me change the color of my pen to understand. Therefore, distance of the vector xy from the origin is traveled as norm x up to this, then later it was norm y. Therefore, this much is a distance between a vector xy and origin. Vector xy and this origin. This is one norm. This may be one norm. I'm not saying this is norm. Actually, our aim is to prove this as a norm, right? This is one way to find out the distance, right? Now, what is the second way to prove the distance? The second way to prove the distance was given to be defining norm of xy is maximum norm x, norm y. Norm x, norm y. That is whichever the distance. This is norm x, this is norm y. Or here, this is norm x and this is norm y. Again, norm on the corresponding spaces n and n dash, I'm assuming to be the shortest distance, right? Therefore, whichever is the maximum will be taken to be the norm. Okay. Or third way to define is norm of an ordered pair xy is norm raised to p, norm y raised to p, whole thing raised to 1 by p. This is very similar to the norm we have defined in the LP spaces. We have defined in the LP spaces. Therefore, these are some particular norms defined on the Cartesian product. Okay. I hope you have understood what is the norm exactly. Now we will go for proving the theorem. Therefore, what the theorem tells us, in the first theorem, we will divide the theorem into two parts. In first part, we will prove it as a nonlinear space, and in the second part, we will go for the completeness proof. Therefore, here, let me write this statement, let n, n dash be normed linear spaces, then prove that n cross n dash, n cross n dash is a normed linear space with coordinate wise operation sorry for the disturbance. Let me again share my screen. This is coordinate wise operations and norm is given by norm of a vector xy is equal to norm x plus norm y, where x is in n and a vector y is in n dash. Okay. Prove that this is a normed linear space with a coordinate wise operation norm xy is equal to norm x plus norm y. Okay, this is the first point I can write, rather this is one. Okay, second part is this norm, prove that this norm induces, this norm induces a product topology. Okay. And third part, we want to prove that n cross n dash is complete. N cross n dash is complete if and only both n and n dash are complete. Both n cross n dash is complete. Okay, therefore let us go for proving the result. That for first step, we will prove that this is In first part, we will prove that this is a non-linear space. Wait for a minute. I'll just reshare the screen. Sorry for the disturbance. Yeah, here we are. Okay, therefore the first part we will try to prove is, we will write step number one, proving okay, there may be some technical issue. I'll stop the lecture for today. In the next lecture, we will go for the proof of this theorem. Proof. In the first step, we will prove that this is a non-linear space. Second, we will prove that this is a product topology. And in the third step, we will prove that n cross n dash is complete if both the spaces are complete. Okay. Thank you for watching the today's lecture.